Hi everybody, I'm John, this is Megumi. Today we're going to be showing you guys a very interesting detail that comes from the bridge and roll that is often forgotten, so hopefully this helps you when you have something big and heavy on top of you and trying to pin you down. Let's have a look. So, Megumi's on top of me here, big, strong, heavy Megumi, okay? And she's come in and she's fed. Guys, the first step, the first thing that needs to happen in the mount is my elbows really need to know, okay, where opponent's femurs are. This is going to help keep your opponent down at your hips, okay, which is very, very important. But nevertheless, Megumi still comes in and she grabs the collar, okay? She comes in for this cross grip. This is dangerous here, so we have to deal with it straight away. So what's going to happen is this hand, okay, isn't going to detach from the femur. What it's going to do is it's going to stay there, and I'm just going to feed it to this side. Okay, and I'm going to lock this down into my chest. Now from this end, what this is going to do is I'm going to grab some fabric, and I'm going to bring Megumi's head into the middle. Okay, so what's going to happen now over here is I want to bring this foot over the top, okay? I want to come with my tippy toes first, so then I can lock my heel. Now the most important part of this, okay, the biggest detail here, the part that people often get wrong, is this basic foot here. What you don't want to do is keep the ankle away from your butt. Because when I do this, if there's even just a little bit of a gap, I'm going to bridge, I'm going to roll, and the Megumi's going to come in and get this grapevine. And this grapevine over here, which Megumi is going to get, if you come in, Megumi get the grapevine? Yeah. That's going to really anchor her and keep her on top. It's not going to let me come over. What you want to do instead, okay, is this foot comes really close into your butt as well. Okay, you can even come onto your tippy toes and bring your heel down. And now there's no space because my calf muscle and my hamstring are connected. So now that I'm here, I'm going to find my tippy toes again. I'm going to bring Megumi's head over me. I'm going to turn my rib cage and I'm going to start to bridge. Now when I bridge, this foot is coming with me. It's coming along, coming along, coming along. And that's how I'm going to come over the top here. Okay. I can pop Megumi's collar grip off, keep my posture, and I'm now safe and on top of this person. Let's try again. So, my elbows always know where opponent's femurs are from the top. Megumi comes in and grabs his deep collar grip. I'm going to feed from this side over to this side and lock it down. Okay, this hand's going to come over the top here. And it's just a way to pull and just slightly manipulate opponent's weight from the top. Now this leg comes up over the top. I lock this leg in. And one more time, it's going to be this leg here that I keep really close to my butt. And now as I'm bridging, I'm here, it keeps coming, keeps coming, keeps coming, keeps coming, keeps coming, until we get that bridge and roll, okay? It's nothing more frustrating when you're trying to bridge and the person keeps getting that grapevine and keeps you on the bottom. So, thanks Megumi. Guys, this is one way, one mechanic that you can use that's really going to help you, especially when you're smaller, when you're weaker, and you have somebody bigger and heavier on top of you. Really need mechanics in order to make this stuff work. This is one of them. So hopefully that helps. Let us know if it does. Thanks Megumi. Thanks guys.